Good morning children, and yesterday's class we learned about the development of reproductive organs. So you know that the proper development of reproductive organs is going to happen in the adolescent period, on the onset of puberty. And you learned the what do we call the primary sexual characters and secondary sexual characters. So primary sexual characters means by birth we are identified as males and females. Is it clear to children? So the characters which we are going to get or which we are identified as male or female, that character we call it as primary sexual character. So secondary sexual characters means what? They are seen in boys and girls separately on the onset of puberty. Means when the boys or girls are going to enter into the adolescent period, so these some changes are going to be seen in the boys and girls. So they are separate. In boys, what is happening? Beard, mustache will be seen, and growth of hair under armpits and near genital organs will be observed. High pitch voice we are going to observe. So whereas in girls, breast development, then soft voice we can observe, then the growth of hair under armpits and near genital organs will be seen. So such characters which are developed at the age of puberty or on the onset of puberty, so are in the adolescent period, so that type of characters are called as a secondary sexual characters. So now in this class we are going to learn about the reproductive phase of life in the human beings. So you know that reproduction is a very very important life process. You learned the in the lesson, the reproduction in animals. So why reproduction is very very important? It helps in continuation of the race. Is it not, children? Yes. So that is the reason reproduction is said to be very very important life process. So what is happening in that process of reproduction? The male and female gametes which are produced by the testes of males, sperms, and ovaries in females, which are going to produce ova, they are going to fuse, that results in the formation of a zygote, where that zygote is developing in the mother's womb. Is it clear to children? So the baby is delivered. So all that you have studied in the previous class. So now here important points you are going to learn. Reproductive phase of life in human beings. Then do you know, children, when the reproductive organs starts functioning? Means you learned already, so that on the onset of puberty, so when we are entering into the period of adolescence, the reproductive organs starts functioning. Is it clear to you? Means what? They starts producing the sperms and ova. Is it clear to you? In females, if we observe, in girls, if we observe, usually the reproductive phase is going to be started in the age of 11 to 14 years. 14 years. In between 11 to 14 years, the girls are going to mature. Means what? The functioning of ovaries will start. But you might have observed also, before the age of 11 only, say in some of the girls, the maturity period is going to be seen. Is it clear to you? So means what? They are maturing much earlier than the stipulated age. Is it clear to you? So what are the reasons for that? Why the girls are maturing much earlier, and what problems the boys are going to face? Means here, as the girls are maturing much earlier, what is the reason? Means that is because of estrogen hormone. Estrogen hormone, which is present in the milk. So we are going to consume milk. Is it clear to you? So that milk is having more and more percentage of estrogen. You know that estrogen hormone, it is a female sex hormone, no doubt. Is it clear to you? So naturally it has to be produced. But what is happening? the food what we are taking, that milk and milk products, especially milk, it contains higher percentage of estrogen, because the cows are injected with this hormones, so that they are going to become pregnant and they are giving birth to calves and we get the milk. So that estrogen whichever is present in the cow's body, so that is seen in the milk, and as we are consuming the milk, so that the people who we are consuming milk, and especially in children of age groups, much earlier, girls especially, they are going to be matured. Is it clear to children? Then in boys, what is happening? Delay. Okay, the production of sperms is getting delayed because of the food habits what we are observing nowadays in the children. Is it clear to you? The capacity of reproductive phase. Reproductive phase means functioning of reproductive organs is much lasting in males than in women. Is it clear to children? Means what? So much of age, so that is up to 70 years also, they are capable of producing sperms in males. Is it clear to you? Whereas in females, this will be stopped by the age of 45 to 50. Okay, so now let us learn how it is happening with the help of a flow chart. So now let us observe through the flow chart. So you know that males, they have the reproductive organs, male sex organs, testes, and females are having ovaries, female reproductive organs. So these testes are going to produce sperms, which are said to be male gametes, and females are going to produce ova, which are said to be the female gametes. And you know that the sperm is going to fuse with the ova. Is it clear to you? So what do we call that process? That process is called as fertilization. The fusion of male gamete with female gamete is called a fertilization. Is it clear to you? So after the fertilization, what will happen? It helps in the formation of a zygote, and zygote is going to develop into baby. But we are not observing as this process is happening continuously. So it is going to result in suppose if the process of fertilization is not happening, that ovum is not going to fuse with the sperm, then what will happen here? You can observe it here. So it waits for the fertilization. The ovum will wait for the fusion, but if fusion is not happening, fusion in a fallopian tube. So if the fertilization happens, fusion happens, it results in fertilization. If the fertilization is not happening, then what will happen? Here it is going to be resulting in a menstruation. What does it mean? So now ovum, if it attains full in size, and the sperms are going to fuse with the ovum, and in the fallopian tube the fertilization is going to happen. Okay, so normally if fertilization happens, zygote going to be produced, and zygote will reach the uterus, and here in the uterus the baby is going to develop. So here the baby will develop. Is it clear to children? So if that process is not happening, what will happen? So here that walls of the uterus, they are going to have some changes. What for? They have to receive the zygote, and the walls of the uterus are going to become thicker, and zygote will develop here. So if the fusion is not happening, what is happening means the walls of this uterus, which are having different types of cells and some amount of blood, so they are getting separated from this part, and it is expelled out of the female body. So that results in the menstruation, okay, or monthly cycle. Is it clear to you? So the ovum will be releasing every month one ovary, that is left ovary. In 1 month, if it is releasing ovum, next month right ovary is going to release the ovum. Is it clear to children? Then the process of fertilization, if it happens, okay. If it is not happening, what will happen means that cells of the uterus and ruptured follicle and that ovum along with some amount of blood, it is expelled out of the female body, which results in the menstrual cycle. So the menstrual cycle, first it starts on the onset of puberty in girls, that is 11 to 14 years it is going to be started, and it will be continued up to the age of 45 to 50. So the first menstrual cycle which is observed in the girls is called a, in the girls, that one we call it as a menarche. Is it clear to you? And it will be observed up to the age of 45 to 50 years. After this period of age, in women, the ovaries will not produce the ovum. So then it is going to be, the menstrual cycle will be stopped. And the last menstrual cycle, whichever is seen, is called as a menopause. Menopause. Is it clear to you, children? Everybody follow? So like that, here the reproductive organs are starting functioning on the onset of a puberty in a boys as well as in a girls. It is actually a wonderful mechanism where it is happening in the female reproductive system, where that so many changes are going to happen in the walls of uterus to bear the baby and all this. It is a wonderful, natural, wonderful mechanism. So you have to give respect to the woman. Is it clear to you, children? Then usually you know that in the beginning the menstrual cycle will be in some girls it is not regular, okay. 1 year, up till 1 year, okay, no problem. Is it clear to you? So yeah, you know that the ovum is going to be released every 28 days to 30 days. Is it clear to you? So in every month, on 28th day to 30th day, the ovum is going to be released. Is it clear to you? So it waits for fertilization, or if it is not waiting for anticipation of pregnancy, then it is going to be expelled out of the female body. That we call it as menstruation. I said no, children. So now that menstrual cycle, if it is irregular, so for 1 year, okay, there is no problem. If irregular periods, if you are observing, then we must consult a doctor who is specialized in treating the problems related to the female reproductive system. What do we call that doctor? So doctor who treats the problems related to the female reproductive system are called as a gynecologist. So you must consult a gynecologist if you have any problem, irregular periods after the period of 1 year, irregular periods if you have. Is it clear to children? So that is about the reproductive phase of life in human beings.